Greetings, fellow things, welcome back to Mirror's Edge. This is most likely the final episode of the game, as per the guide that I saw. I just like to open up guides and just see how the content in the game is split out so that it can help me split the content that I record easier. So according to that, this is most likely the last episode of the game, so welcome to the final episode of Mirror's Edge. Faith has just saved Sister Kate, and however, she was hiding her at Merc's lair, and since the people behind Project Icarus knew about Mercury, they promptly raided his lair and took Kate with them, probably to make sure that she takes the fall for the murder of Robert Pope. She's currently being held at the Shard, which is the mayor's place, which explains all the cops trying to suppress this conspiracy. And so Faith is headed right there, right into the Shard, to make sure that Kate is liberated and this entire grasp for power is laid to rest once and for all. So that's where we began. Now, I do hope that this level doesn't have any of the annoying repetitive combat sections that I've faced in the previous few levels. Those are honestly really killing the vibe of the game for me, but apart from that, I've digressed. I've prattled on for long enough, essentially, so let us go ahead and kick this finale off then. Here we go.
They go.
I heard them mention the Shard.
The mayor's place?
Yeah.
Shit, Mark. Let me get someone, a doctor.
Ain't gonna happen, Faith.
I'm sorry, Mark. I'm so sorry.
No sorries. Just don't let them win.
I won't, Mark.
Thanks, kiddo.
I must admit, this piece looks pretty, and I do like the soundtrack in this section, but I honestly don't know how good it'll come along as a level, I mean. So how am I supposed to get up there? Very good question indeed. And right off the bat, we are stuck. Yeah, we can't get up there. The pipes, following the pipes perhaps. The game presented me with a path and I took it. Okay, see something here. That's not where I wanted to go. Come on, Faith. You can do better. Exactly. Run along the walls, just like that. And where to from here? Like, why did I even come here? Is like just a pointless extra area? Seems to be the case, because there's nowhere else I can go from here. There's something, there's like an open door back there. So maybe this, we're meant to go there then, I suppose. Nothing here either. Pretty sure there won't be any runner stashes over there. So I suppose we're going up there then. However we can manage to do that. Interesting. So this is essentially the gate that we used to come in. Alright. I see. I see what's going on here. Can we run up here? Nope, no we cannot. Can't even go there. Alright. I see something to get on top there. Question is, how am I gonna access it? For certain, I cannot run along these walls. Or can I? Like, running and jumping from here is not going to solve anything. And running and jumping from down there isn't going to solve anything either, so... I suppose the only alternative present to us is this. Which, strangely enough, worked. I did not think it would work, but it did. I hope we did not have to jump down there. Well, if it did, it's too late to do that now, anyway. Excuse me there. Alright, maintenance access. Let's kick the door open for a change. What's happened? Oh, that was just my door itself. Gas under pressure. Okay, I don't think I want to open this up. I suppose that's the only way then. This might just kill us. I'm gonna run all the way over to the other end. Oh shit. Yeah, I'll hide away right here. Makes sense. Makes sense. Maybe we should turn this off now. Or not. Or not. Let's just continue onwards. That is bound to alert everybody in the area. How do you not die to a headshot, son? Give me your gun. Yeah, thank you. The thing that I like about using these guns is the fact that you can actually run with them. But running with other guns is sort of a risk. Like, you can't always run with the other guns. You're dead now. Aren't you? Give me that machine gun. I see a door right here. I would like to take it. And this just brings us back here. Kicking down doors left and right. Shooting cops dead. That is what this all has come down to. I'm gonna shoot you down with your own weapon, son. If that's the last thing that I do. Pretty sure the stowaway strategy won't be working again. Now the question remains, where the hell am I going? I can still hear combat music, meaning that there's at least one more cop around here. Well, I see an open door there, so that's probably where I'm headed. And given the number of rounds and the damage that this thing does, I'm unwilling to let go of this thing, for the time being at least. Well, that does nothing for us. Maybe up there? Or maybe in there, who knows. But there's nothing in here. Any more cops? None? I do see something like a V, but... Oh, okay. My bad. That was totally my bad. Totally missed that. Why did you throw that, Faith? Come on, we can use this. Keep it with you.
Security firm Durandello Kruger have been authorized to draft in more units until Kate Connors has been re-secured. It is believed that Connors may have been helped by the missing fugitive from the Robertsville murder scene. More updates on the hour.
At least it's not runners.
Good work, Checker.
You gonna shoot me too?
Why?
No. Right now, you're Kate's best hope.
Weren't these your guys?
No, they're PKs. Pirandello Kruger. Private security.
What's going on, Miller?
Hope's murder. Turns out there was a man on the inside.
Ropeburn?
Yes. You were right about him. I tried to get answers myself.
Sorry, Mr. Suit.
They needed a CPF cop to look like Pope's killer. No time to explain more. Take this comms unit and head for the roof. It's where they've taken Kate. I'll contact you when it's safe. I'll hold them off. The roof. Go! Now!
Now this guy seems much more badass. Okay, looks like we're finding a way around them. Like, if that is an alternative, then that is like what I'm going to do. Okay, that's not the way we're headed. We're supposed to be going, I suppose. I've got no idea why I did that, but I did that nonetheless, so here we are. Oh, I see. I'm supposed to call the elevator. Alright, once more onto the breach. Apologies for the lag if this does make it to the final cut of the game. Why the fuck did you have to lag this so hard? Anybody else? There's supposed to be at least one more here. There you are. Cool. I swear, machine guns are all you need, really. Yeah, so we essentially had to eliminate them. Nonetheless, like, regardless. Emergency hatch open. Only in case of emergency. Oh. I wonder if we have to get up there. Emergency hatch open only in case of emergency.
Welcome to the Shire. Constructed in 2012 by the renowned architect J.C. Thomas. This monumental building has over 100 floors of both commercial and
residential. I tend to forget that this game came out in 2005. I'm at retro gaming right now, I feel like I am.
Drop any weapons you have, stay where you are, and prepare to be taken into custody.
Thank you for visiting. Have a safe and productive day.
Alright, so where are we headed now?
Are you reading me? I'm in the security room, tracking you on the cameras. Get out of the elevator, they're coming.
I've already done that, like gotten out of the elevator. Question is, where am I supposed to head next?
No sign of her!
Keep working, spread out your knees!
That's too fast to get onto, pretty certain about that. It's telling me I have to go down there, but how? How is the question? All the alternatives presented seem pretty much like a dead sentence. Let's try it. Woo! Barely made it. Interesting. Okay, now we also need to be watching out for all of these things that keeps swinging about, please.
In the elevator shaft. Listen, there should be an entrance to the ventilation system somewhere in there. It'll take you outside, but you should be able to find a way back in on the other side of the building. Might just be enough to throw them off the scent.
Thank you. How am I supposed to get there, though, is the question. Alright, let's go. We made it this side. Now we need to jump onto there. Holy shit, this level is precarious, to say the least. Okay, I'll just rest here for a bit. Oh yeah. They can definitely. That thing can definitely come down from there. There's like another level that we need to be worried about. But it seems like the central line is more or less clear. Like nothing ever comes down the central line, from the looks of it. I saw another one of those red things there. What the fuck? Oh, give me a break, yes. Come on, get up. She takes a while getting up and into places. Alright, we're gonna wait for one of these things to go. Yeah. Should be okay to move. Alright, done. Now then. As soon as we see one of these things move, we're gonna take that. Safe for now. And the central shaft is pretty safe, so you don't really need to bother about that. Faith went. Oh! I don't know how she was balancing in the middle of those things there, but. Yeah. I'll just wait for the ones in the center to. Yeah. Time to move now. Alright. This probably takes us back up. And, like Miller said, outside of the building. I see. I totally forgot that this mechanic exists in the game because they haven't really shown it since the beginning. Oh, okay. It's pretty fucking dark here. Excuse me a second there. Huh, I like. What the fuck? Well, at least it starts from here. I didn't even notice that there's like nothing back there. Seriously? Okay, looks like we are running and then jumping. Seriously, that's all you can run? Okay, we made it thus far. Question is, where to next? Like, it's. Stuff here is so dark, I can hardly see anything. I mean, I can see something there. Question is, yeah, we don't want to go there, we actually want to go there. Should we, yeah, thought as much. Alright then. We are still technically in the elevator shaft. I hit the crouch button, come on. Seems like the only way forward. What am I doing here? Nothing, it's literally just a trap. That's all it is. Unless. Where is November? Who's November?
I was too young to remember exactly how it started. The authorities said the changes were for the greater good. But good isn't the same as right.
Is November like your mom or something, Faith? That would sort of make sense. So I guess we headed this way? Alright. Same mechanic right here. try to roll. Thank you. Thank you for rolling. Alright, so we headed this way.
I see you now. There's a sniper team guarding this area. You can get back in on the other side. Be careful, Faith.
Nice level design this far. Like, the combat isn't particularly difficult. By a large margin, at least. I say that as I get shot. Somebody tried taking a shot at me. That doesn't seem to be high voltage there. All their sidelines are crossed. Alright, let's go. But where to from here? Yeah, I definitely don't want to be on that side. Should be safe here, for now at least. Yeah, don't know why I did that. That's stupid. When faced with snipers, that's the most stupid thing that decision that I can make. Alright, we're going down again. And back here, but... Oh, I see. I see why I did that. Alright, that makes sense. Evaded that rather nicely, I would say. Come on! Probably should have hit a bit there. Let's go ahead and do that now. Here we are! They tried shooting, but yeah, we ain't gonna let them shoot us. I see a sniper right there. It's sort of like they know exactly where we are. I did not see his red dot there. So where to next? There's like a barbed wire fence on that side. This side seems to be unfenced though. Okay. We're clear till like a long duration right here. High voltage? Where? Oh, over there? Alright. This is interesting. This is definitely an interesting section. I see the first sniper there. I don't see the rest of them though. Where did the rest go? The only way through involves getting by that guy. There's one over there and one behind me. There are a total of three snipers, one is somewhere over there. Where is this guy? In the building? Well, that's the end that is moving. So is that end. There's some sort of camera trickery going on right here. Let's try this. Thank you for the gun. It'll be greatly useful for me. Where's the other guy? In there? Yeah, I can't seem to shoot you. And this guy is more or less a dud at this point, so... I suppose we might as well just leave him be. That seems to be the way back in. Interesting. Is this, like, literally the only way? This is going to be a tight one. save me, dog. Here we are, finally. And excuse me one more second there. Kick the door down and then move in. I doubt that is where. Oh yeah, this is where we're headed.
There's an elevator ahead. I've managed to unlock it.
Oh,
take it to
you.
The server room. You should be able to get to the top floors and Kate from there.
Well, designed level structure. No, like, unnecessarily difficult fights in this section. Like, this game being all about flow, whenever a certain fight section breaks it, it just sort of feels.
It looks like the security doors to the roof are closed, okay. If you destroy those servers, their emergency protocol should automatically unlock the doors. I hope. Good luck, Faith.
You hope?
Look around. Surveillance for the whole city right under your nose, Faith.
That's Project Icarus.
Sounds like they've taken Kate to the roof. They've got a chopper coming in. You have to be quick. What the...
Miller. Here we go.
Miller.
Seriously?
Look around. Surveillance for the whole city right under your nose, Faith. Sounds like they've taken Kate to the roof. They've got a chopper coming in. You have to be quick.
That's definitely where we have to go, so.
Miller.
Any more? None? I see one right there. That was funny. No move for the time being, I suppose. Like, there's nothing here. But we still do need to destroy the servers. Oh, those are the servers. Okay, gotcha. Question is, how do we get to them? Destroy them, I mean. Corners are clear. Thus far. Oh, okay, that's all. I'm guessing I'm gonna need a little more firepower. Yeah, no, that's not gonna work. Looks like it's like only one server per section. Good thing these guys have guns all over the place. Because, they probably knew that we're gonna need these guns. I mean, they designed the game in such a manner. So we're gonna need the guns. Isn't this how I get there? Or is it like something more to be done yet? What's going on? Have we harmed that? Yes, we have. We've harmed this, we've harmed that, we've harmed this. Which one is the one that's remaining? Yeah, we've destroyed all of them. Is something up, open up there now? I'm not really getting any. Oh, yeah. Access is now available. Cool. I'm carrying this thing with me in case of any further fights. Getting shot in this game might not be fun, but clear. shooting folks in this game definitely is. Alright, looks like we're gonna have to get rid of this. Give me a second there. Right before the finale, or what seems to be the finale. I wonder if this is gonna be a boss fight of sorts. Seems like the stage is set for that. Jackknife.
Hello, Faith.
Jackknife. If you couldn't.
Attitudes like that. Well, that's exactly why I could.
Who's behind this?
Let's just say I know who the bigger fish are.
Callahan. Why us? We're no threat.
Classic warfare. Break the lines of communication. Shoot the messengers. Without Pope. And without the runners. Your clients, those who just won't let go of the old city, will be cut off, vulnerable, and this city can clean up the last of its dregs.
So this is just the start?
I prefer to think of it as an ending. Still, you did a remarkably good job of coaxing out all those loose ends surrounding Pope's demise. It's why you're still alive.
I see. Only one alternative left for me at this point. Come on then. Woohoo! Looks like he shot the rotor on the way down. Kate! Whew, she seems fine for now. Now what about the SWAT back there? Pretty pop movie sort of ending there actually. I mean, first off, what happened to the damn SWAT? And like, yeah, pretty abrupt and pretty pop movie sort of ending there. I mean, the game was nice, but it definitely requires refinement in a lot of things. I mean, the first thing that I can think of right off the top of my head is how, oh yeah, that just reminds me, this soundtrack might just be copyright protected, so yeah, I don't know whether I want to approve this. Maybe I'll replace it somehow, I'll look into it. Anyhow, back to what I was saying. The combat encounters in this game feel out of place. I mean, they're not fluid, they feel very out of place. So, I mean, if they had made it to where you could flow through the combat as well, that would have been something amazing, but especially towards the end. Especially the last few levels, like Pirandi or Kruger, and Kate, essentially the level that is called Kate, and this one level, the Shard. They literally added a few combat levels that were, not exactly fitting for this game. Like, there are times where it actually turned into a first-person shooter instead of like a parkour platformer, and that's pretty sad actually. I mean, I feel like they sort of, it's something that's antithetical to the game, antithetical to the philosophy of free running is what I feel like. So, and the second thing is of course the the parts where you, with the parkour in this game, is actually like a series of interactions. And I mean, apart from the fact that this game is a little slow, the running in this game, and she takes a while to pick up speed, and I guess like, you can chalk all of that up to realism, but the parkour in this game is very, how to put this, iffy. Things don't always work the way they're supposed to. I mean, it's like you're interacting with different things instead of actually running freely like the game would have you believe. So for example, if I'm right next to a wall and there's like a hurdle in between, I won't jump onto the wall and start running running along it. Yeah, so basically, whenever you interact, it's more like a chain of interactions instead of like a free running formula where the game more or less, you know, picks the proper context based on your height or your level or elevation or whatever. And so yeah, it's sort of, that is an area of the game which could definitely use far more refinement. The story was fine, it was sort of like an investigative thriller sort of thing. And well, it was fine. It wasn't anything too good. The ending was totally something pop cinema, but I mean, there is further meaning to it, especially once you listen to this little news report right there at the end. The fact that the world goes on, corruption wins, politicians are gonna politic, and yeah, there's literally nothing that one person can do to change it, but for Faith Corners, all that mattered was a sister, and she got her in the end. Even though the mayor is still out there, and he is still pulling all the strings behind the scenes, at least Faith and Kate are safe for the time being. And, well, even though they might have to live in hiding, they're not behind bars, or dead. So, yeah, so I suppose all things considered, that was somewhat of a good ending, even though she could not really stop the flow of time or the march of these powerful forces. Still, she got what she really wanted, her sister, all safe and sound. Yeah, apart from that, the visuals in this game are stunning, and I feel like they could have really made the visuals look prettier. Because in most cases the visuals are just like a canvas of white with very little shades in between, and this game does not have an HDR. Perhaps with Mirror's Edge Catalyst they have utilized HDR to make it look better, but for this game, yeah, it just looks like a canvas of blinding white, and that's all there is. Maybe that has something to do with the fact that the game is called Mirror's Edge, but yeah. Even the soundtrack is nice, it's good where it is, it's apt in all its places is all I'll say. Like, it's ambient but electronic at the same time, so yeah. At a rate, that's the credits. Like, these are the end of the credits as well, so thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around not until only the end of this finale, but also the end of this entire playthrough. So when we come back, we will be continuing on with Mirror's Edge Catalyst. But before that, I think I'll play binary domain a little bit. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow worldlings.